Sonia, you are related to beauty pageant, and when we talk about beauty, we always think that if you are stressed, if you have a lot of tensions, it would reflect on your face and you'll probably have more wrinkles than you should have. So how do you balance yourself in terms of the pressures and the tensions? And also, what are the tips that you share with the contestants?
You know, that's a good question. Like, there is a lot of stress, but there's time management and self-realization. When you know what you like, you will not get stressed. When you know how to solve problems and you know exactly how to do things, you won't get stressed. Like, if I'm in problems, like, I don't go crazy. I'll sit down, relax, and I'll think of a solution. So my approach is always think of a solution rather than, you know, start pulling your hair and go crazy. So I think that it will help me, and I hope I stay like this for the next 100 years. So I'm hoping for that, fingers crossed.
Wonderful. So we'll be there to see you after 100 years. Staying calm and learning to see where lies the solution is a wonderful attribute that is relevant for one and all. Now, the biggest problem that you see in terms of the growth of, if I refer to this as an industry, beauty pageant industry, with all this economic turmoil that the whole world is facing. So, of course, you'll have trouble in finding the sponsors and you'll have trouble in involving more people. How you have taken care of that?
Definitely. There's like recession has been going on since about a good 1.5 years now. So there are ways to, you know, encounter those problems. Maybe we cut the pageant a little bit shorter. We, you know, go for a shorter or smaller audience. So those things are always taken into account, and that way we are always safe. So I don't think any of the years have gone by without a Miss Pakistan World. We've had great big ones, we've had mediocre ones, and so forth. So it just depends on the economy basically of the country. As I said, you have to find a solution. You can't just say no and, you know, stop it then and there. So definitely we found a solution and we cut back on costs and things like that. But I think it's going pretty good now.
Very nice. I'm really happy to hear that. And in the past 7 years journey of Miss Pakistan pageant and then this Miss Pakistan pageant, you must have met many people. Some of them must have been very encouraging, very positive. Who sort of added to your strength? Any such names that comes to your mind?
You know, for the Mrs. Pakistan pageant, let me clarify, I never faced a problem. It's because the husbands were in control and the in-laws and the parents were not in control. So the wives were more active, much happier to be a part of the pageant. I found it easier for a Mrs. Pakistan in the beginning as compared to a Miss Pakistan in the beginning. But for me, my role model, if you had asked, you know, what gives me the strength, would be, I think President Musharraf, because even though he came from a different door, he made sure that the media, entertainment was open. People started getting other things to do. I respect him for that. And besides women's rights and so forth, the usual that he has done, he changed the culture of the country. Today, if you go to Karachi and Lahore and places like that, yes, again, you might see the fanatics, but you will also see the moderate or modern people. Before, they used to be in hiding. Now they have come out in the opening.
So, surprisingly, President Musharraf has inspired people at a wide range. People who are related to beauty pageants also have found something in him. Have you read his autobiography?
Yes, I have. Yes.
And what is it that you found sort of stood out in your mind?
What I really found beautiful about President Musharraf was the fact that he was a person from a middle-class family. His mother was educated, his father was educated, his mother was a teacher, and family worked all their lives. So he's not one of those elite classes where, you know, they have so much, you know, land, or they have the zamindars or something like that. He's not one of those. He's one of us. We are the middle class. He represented the middle class people. That is the main thing that I liked. And secondly, he believed in whatever he said. If he said no, it meant no. That was, I like that military you can say dictatorship attitude, but I liked it because our country, Pakistan, needed somebody to pull them by the ears and make them understand that this is the way to do things. Because lots of leaders went and, I mean, came and, you know, went away, but nobody actually taught them how to, you know, live the life as a moderate person. And I think he has, you know, basically given that chance to the people, and he has actually directed those people in that direction.
Sonia, you are not only well-versed with the way girls look beautiful, you have also increased their interest in the politics of Pakistan. So now let me ask you a question. In India and in most of the Indian media, we hear and read that politicians in Pakistan need to say something against India in order to survive, and that is one way of gaining votes. Is that true?
Well, I think both sides are doing it. I won't blame Pakistan only. I have watched Indian news as well on all Indian channels. I'll see somebody saying against Pakistan, and on Pakistan channels too, some of the local or the main politicians would say the same thing. Again, it's a way of living for India and Pakistan, I think. Both are not understanding that they need to resolve rather than, call each other names or things like that, or, you know, say something about each other. I know the Mumbai attacks happened, and it was an embarrassment. As a Pakistani, I would say it was an embarrassment for me. But that doesn't mean that I wanted that to happen. And that doesn't also mean that it's an excuse for me to cover up whoever came from Pakistan to do that. So, but that has to be understood by the Indians on that side. Tomorrow, if there's somebody who comes in, I mean, you never know what can happen tomorrow and does the same thing with us. We have to have the tolerance to say, okay, the people are not bad, some of the people are bad. So there has to be a difference. Instead of, you know...
Actually, allow me to...